So in this video, we're gonna learn about generation of carbene or preparation of carbene, how carbene is prepared. So we have seen it exists two types of carbene. One is singlet carbene and one is triplet carbene. So first method to prepare the carbene is alpha elimination over here. If the elimination is from the alpha carbon, then it is called alpha elimination. So the reagent we are using is the base with high temperature, and the here we have CHCl3 in presence of KOH. So when CHCl3 react with KOH, so first of all there is an acid base reaction. H plus takes over this hydroxide ion, takes over this H plus, and there is a Cl, then it will be a negative charge over here. Now it is a H2O, and carbon with negative charge having chlorine, chlorine and chlorine, three bond with chlorine, and it is having negative charge over here. Now as we are applying the higher temperature and we are supplying the higher temperature, so this chlorine will leave from here, and it is two unpaired orbit of p, orbital of p, or we have in that one is empty and one has two lone pair. And if we try to see, means the carbene we are talking about here, it is a singlet carbene. Here we are forming a singlet carbene. Singlet carbene we are forming because the chlorine has lone pair. So a resonance is possible here, means these two lone pair of chlorine are, these are making a resonance over here. So the carbon should have a pure p orbit. It should have a fully empty p orbit. P orbital. It should have a fully empty p orbital to accept the electrons. So that's how it is forming. So that's how it will form a singlet carbene due to resonance over here. So the driving force of the carbene formation here is high temperature. We are providing the high temperature to form the carbene. Carbene is easily formed in those reactions in which there is a reacting species. So whenever there is a reacting species, carbene will form. And suppose if we have the different halogen, like we have iodine here, we have bromine here, we have fluorine here. So the leaving group tendency, first of all iodine will leave, then bromine will leave, then chlorine will leave, then fluorine will leave. So it is leaving tendency of halogens. Carbene react with alkene alkyne to form three member link. Literally we will see the reaction where the carbene reacts with double bond, the alkene, and carbene react with alkyne. So it gets attached over this alkene and alkyne. So this type of reaction we will be seeing further. Now if we talk about the second method, which is CCl4 plus RLi. So RLi is organometallic compound, R having a negative charge, lithium is a positive charge. So this will form a carbene. So let's see how it is forming the carbene. Again R, the alkyl group we are using over here, in that the R is having negative charge and it is attacking on this chlorine. When it is attacking this chlorine, this is forming a bond RCl, and these electron pair will shift towards carbon. Now when these are shifting towards carbon, there is a negative charge. Now when this is again proceed further, so again if we providing the temperature, the required temperature to the solution, the chlorine will leave out the solution, and there will be formation of, again here will we get singlet carbene. Here the carbene we are getting is singlet carbene. Again, why we are getting singlet carbene? Because there we call it back bonding. Because there the back bonding is happening, or here also if we specialize this, it is also here a back bonding. When the outer atom donates its lone pair to the central atom, then it is categorized as a back bonding. So here again we are getting singlet carbene, because in case of back bonding, the carbon need a fully empty p orbital, means a fully empty p orbital to accept those electrons. So that's why we are getting a singlet carbene here. This carbene, where both of the electrons are in the same shell and it is sp2 hybridized, we have seen in the introduction of carbene how we are categorizing the carbene. Now the next method of preparation we are observing is from diazomethane. So diazomethane is CH2N2. So CH2N2, it is a diazomethane. So when this, so this is diazomethane and it is having two canonical structure. One is this canonical structure and next is this canonical structure, which are interconverted to each other, which interconverts into each other. So diazomethane, first of all, when the condition we need to make the carbene is, first of all, it should be in the presence of light. Second, we are heating, and third is keeping the solution at higher temperature, when it is at higher temperature. So when we go through these three steps, so it is a formation of nitrogen and nitrogen gas, and this is forming a carbene. So when carbene is put in under the polar solvent, so here N2 gas releases and there is a formation of carbene. If we want to see how the carbene is forming, this is in this type of resonance. So when we are providing the high temperature, so in nitrogen takes this electron and carbon forms a carbene. Okay, so when carbon having, and this we have seen previously in case of CnCl3, when it forms Cl, Cl and Cl with negative charge. So when carbon has three bond with negative charge and that one bond is moving outside with taking an electron, or carbon is donating an electron. So how many electrons are left here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 electrons are left here. So in that's how we form the carbene. Now this is carbene. Now how we will decide whether it is a singlet carbene or it is a triplet carbene? So in all ways, when we are forming a carbene, when it is putting under polar solvent, when the solvent is polar, it has a lone pair to donate, like H2O, other polar solvent, you know, aldehyde, ketone, all are polar solvent, which has oxygen and other species which are lone pair. So these species can donate lone pair to its empty orbital. So whenever we have a donatable species which can donate electron to the carbene, so there should be an empty orbital, that's why it is a singlet carbene. Whenever there is one empty orbital, that is singlet carbene. When it is a gas phase or inert solvent, the solvent which is inert in nature, then in case there will be formation of triplet carbene. So with these conditions, we know the carbene will form, but which type of carbene will form will depend on the solvent condition, whether it is a polar solvent or it is a gas phase or inert solvent. So if we talk about ketene, so what are ketene actually? In ketone, when the next bond is double bond. So here carbon is sp hybridized. If you see, it is here sp hybridized. So here again we need all the three conditions. So now all the three conditions, we are providing the light, we are providing the heat, and we are keeping the solution at higher temperature. So in that case, it is formation of carbene, and there will be a gas will move outside the solution, which is a carbon monoxide. So here, this ketene we have, and ketene, it is in resonance, it has a resonating structure. This is a resonating structure over here. So here again there is a positive charge on oxygen and negative charge of carbon. Again it could show a resonance here. So these both structures are canonical structure of each other, or resonating structure. Now again we are heating the solution, providing in presence of light, keeping high temperature. So the bond will break. Again, whenever the carbon has three bond with negative charge and one bond is breaking, so outermost electrons are 6 electrons. So that's how it is forming the carbene. So when it is forming the carbene, here again, when it don't have chlorine here, if you see, it don't have chlorine here. In the previous example, we also see it don't have chlorine here. or it don't have any electron which have element which have electron pair, which donates and clearly show singlet alkene. So in this type of condition, which type of alkene is there? It depends on solvent condition. So whatever will be the solvent condition, that type of alkene or that type of carbene will form.